up, Melissa. I don't know if I'm in the right place or not. I want to buy a going away present.
Well, we have them for both ways, going and coming. Who's the gift for?
Well,
your mother.
No, my girl.
Oh. Well, back to school, I'll bet.
Uh-huh. But I don't see any back to school stuff.
Well, how about this to remember you by at school?
Bong! It's got AM, FM, FC, MX.
Well, I'm sure she'll like it.
Oh, but she's already got a portable radio.
She has one.
But, I haven't. Nope, I've got to get something for her. I'm sorry to be such a kook about this. I'm just not good at things like this.
Well, I'm setting no records here either. Let's see now. What did you give your fiancé for her birthday?
Well, nothing. I mean, I just met her a month ago today.
An anniversary. No. Congratulations. Well, how about something she'd consider a real luxury? Is she about my size?
Oh, sort of.
36, would you say?
Well, maybe you'd better ask her.
Well, they'll be wearing this on every campus this fall.
Well, I'll be sure to tell her. Or, maybe I could bring her in. Or maybe she could phone or something. Maybe.
Through these fingers slip the most wonderful customers in the world. All right! Why not the superior male routine any time now? Seriously, Walter, how do you get through to people like that?
Ask her.
Ask who?
The airline hostess. After all, you two have things in common.
We're both dummies.
You're both in the people-to-people business.
Yeah, but you've got seatbelts to keep them hog-tied with. Well, I don't think the luggage looks good that way.
I think the luggage looks very nice that way. And you both deal in TLC.
In English, please.
Tender loving care.
Oh, tender loving care, huh? Well, maybe I should get a uniform.
Melissa, please.
You're pawing her, Walter.
It is not my practice to paw young ladies. There. No, Melissa, it isn't the uniform. It's your mental attitude, your self-control, your patience. It's what's inside the uniform that counts.
Walter, you've been reading thick books again.
I've seen it work.
Jacket still doesn't fit right.
The jacket fits fine. Yes, Melissa, I've seen TLC in action. I remember this one flight. There was a young man.
Will you fasten your seatbelts,
please. These are a little tricky. Here, let me help you. It does make a lot of noise on the ground. We'll be taking off very shortly. Is this your first flight with us?
This is my first flight with anyone.
Well, you're going to love it. Are you comfortable?
Should I move?
All the comforts of home.
You see what I mean, Melissa? The way she handled the situation, I'll bet that fellow became a customer on that airline. And all because she follows a simple rule in dealing with people.
And what's the rule? I know I'm supposed to ask.
The people-to-people rule is simply this. Put them at ease, treat them as guests, and make them feel important.
I'd say I always treat people all right.
Always? Listen, wasn't it only yesterday you raised your voice to a little old lady?
Who raised her voice? I never raise my voice.
Melissa, you were practically yelling at her.
That little old lady told me the battery in her hearing aid was weak. I did not yell!
Okay, the little old lady was having a bad day. But remember this, Melissa. The customer can afford to have a bad day. That's his privilege. Well, we can afford only good ones.
You sound like a fortune cookie.
But you know, this rule works no matter what type of customer is involved. I saw an airline stewardess follow this rule and handling an entirely different type of person. You might say she was an unusual person in several ways. Miss?
May I help you, Mrs. Wilson?
There's a snake up there. It has been hissing at me.
Snake?
Yes, and I hiss.
Oh, that's just the air vent.
Air vent? Turn it off! I'm still chilly. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Isn't that cozy? Miss?
Yes, Mrs.
Wilson. I'm sorry to be such a bother.
Oh, yes, it's never a bother, Mrs. Wilson. You know that.
Oh, I've made such a fuss, haven't I? Everyone's eyes are on me, aren't they?
Hmm? No, nobody's looking.
Oh, they're not?
No, if you'll excuse me, I'll see about serving lunch.
Yes. Miss? Miss?
Oh, yes, Mrs. Wilson.
May I have a glass of water? It's time for my pill.
Of course.
Oh, Miss?
Yes, Mrs. Wilson?
I think I'll write some letters. Do you have a bright stationery with a red and blue stripe?
Mm? Yes, I'll bring some right away.
Oh, thank you, child.
Mrs. Wilson?
Yes?
They're all looking now.
They are? Thank you, dear.
Same simple rule work there, too. Put them at ease, treat them as guests, and make them feel important.
Something not clear, Melissa?
Walter, that wasn't related to you in any way, was she?
No, why?
Oh, nothing. Just that... Oh, nothing.
Mm-hmm. But did you get the point?
Sure. He takes out of airplanes and don't turn your back on old ladies.
Melissa, I give up.
Walter. Walter, I was just kidding. I'll be serious, but you be serious, too. You want me to believe that people-to-people rule of yours works with all types of people.
I do.
Including the overbearing good time Charlie that was in here this morning.
Including?
The fellow who stacked all those Tyrolean hats on his head, rolled up his pant legs and yodeled.
Including?
And sprayed you with my sin and thought it was very funny.
Including?
Man, what a rule.
An airline hostess deal with that type of person. He was sort of unusual, too.
Well, hello there, beauty queen. How are you?
You rang, Mr. Blart?
Yeah, glad you could come, darling. How are you? That's pretty fine. Pretty girl. Say, I got a little present for you.
Oh, no, thank you.
Oh, come on.
No,
here,
no,
you take that.
No.
Now, go ahead, open it. Surprised you, did I?
You certainly did.
I got a million of those. All magic. Takes a lot of practice, I'll tell you that.
Oh, you're in show business.
Well, yes, in a way, though. Entertainers, parties, PTA, that kind of thing.
Well, I think that's wonderful.
My real line is the clamshell bucket business. Earth-moving equipment, big stuff. Say, I'll tell you. Oh, now, here, look at this. Did you ever see anything like this at all? Whip, boom.
Oh, my. That's quite a display, Mr. Bart.
Little girl, I want to tell you something. There isn't a place in this country that I don't know about and who the people are and what's all about. Now, play a little game. Sit right down there and just ask me questions. Try to stump me if you can.
Well, that sounds like an interesting challenge, Mr. Block, but you will have to excuse me. We're going to be serving lunch in just a few minutes.
Well, that's good. I'll give you a hand, baby.
Oh, well, it's very nice of you to offer, but...
Ah, shucks. No bother at all. I always offer to help out.
I'd rather have you do me a big favor. Would you fill out one of these forms telling how you like the service on this flight? It would mean a lot, you know, coming from an experienced traveler like you.
Oh, these little things. Well,
I understand the president of the company often looks them over.
The president looks these over, does he? Is that right? Well, the president, eh? Oh!
Put them at ease, treat them as guests, and make them feel important. The same simple rule worked again.
Well, you're making a case, Perry Mason.
Oh, of course, sometimes you have to work a little harder on one part of the rule than another, but the end result is always the same. A satisfied customer.
Regardless of type of person.
Of course. It could be a grouch. Could be any other type. Of course, these are really exceptions. Let's face it, Melissa. Most people are swell. They're wonderful as passengers or customers, but they all have one thing in common.
Well, I know. They want tender, loving care.
More than one. They crave it. And since they're customers, they should get it. It's like a product. When a customer asks for a specific product by name, he should get it.
Same thing, huh?
Ask her, she'll tell you. There's no substitute for the real thing.